Welcome to the California Department of Education Integrated and Designated English Language Development Transitional Kindergarten through Grade 12 video series. Mathematics with Integrated English Language Development in Grade 8. The students have been engaging in tasks where they solve real-world application problems using systems of equations as part of a unit on linear equations. In this lesson, the students work collaboratively to unpack and solve a word problem using a system of equations and key information from the text. At the end of the lesson, the students engage in a class discussion, explaining how they unpack the problem and solve the equation. The California Common Core State Standards for Mathematics, driving the lesson. The mathematics standard is Grade 8 Expressions and Equations, Standard 8C. Analyze and solve pairs of simultaneous linear equations, where students solve real-world and mathematical problems, leading to two linear equations in two variables. Watch for how this California standard is addressed throughout the lesson. The supporting California English language development standards used in tandem with the mathematics standards. The English language development standards at the bridging level are Grade 8, Part 1, Standard 1, exchanging information and ideas, where students contribute to class, group, and partner discussions by following turn-taking rules, asking relevant questions, affirming others, adding relevant information and evidence, paraphrasing key ideas, building on responses, and providing useful feedback. And Grade 8, Part 1, Standard 12A, selecting language resources, where students use an expanded set of general academic words, domain-specific words, synonyms, antonyms, and figurative language to create precision and shades of meaning while speaking and writing. Watch how students move from early levels of proficiency toward the bridging levels of these English language development standards throughout the lesson. Watch how the teacher leads the students toward accurate expression of their math content knowledge by providing opportunities for them to collaboratively read and analyze academic text with a partner, unpack and discuss the meaning of the mathematical concepts within the problem, write a linear equation, and then explain how they solve the problem using domain-specific vocabulary.
So there are three key features that we are going to try to do today. One, we are going to solve a system of equations problem, which we've been doing for a really long time. Two, we are going to communicate with others how you solved it. So we are really going to practice verbally explaining to each other how you solved the problem. I always ask you guys why, so you are used to that explaining part, but now you're going to try to explain it from start to finish. And then if we have time, we're going to begin our explanation, the writing part of it. Okay, so we're going to start off with a new problem. So I'm going to pass this out to you guys, and the first thing I want you to do is read it quietly to yourself. We are going to look at this chunk by chunk by chunk, so I broke it up into little pieces. So you and your partner, you guys are going to have an extended conversation now, and I want you guys to look at each piece of this text, and I want you to write, what is it talking about, what information is it giving us?
And cost $1 for any service plus 90 cents for each topic.
So that's the cost,
for each topic.
For the cheese pizza, the large cheese pizza and the toppings.
It's like the cost of the pizza and then the toppings.
So it's talking about how many of the toppings you had to put on both of the pizza.
Okay, but I don't get it because it was saying how many toppings need to be added to a large cheese pizza from Pizza Hut and round tip. Like, what is it basically trying to say?
It's like basically saying that you're just putting like toppings on both of the pizza.
Okay,
so you're adding like toppings to it.
But like, you know, okay, so you know what I'm saying, but how about if you want a pizza like without topping, is it still gonna cost the same thing?
Did you read the question? In order for the pizzas to cost the same. So it's saying that how many of the toppings you had to put on both pizza for them to equal the same.
Okay, so how, so what are we trying to find? Yeah?
How to make the large cheese pizza from Pizza Hut, I mean not Pizza Hut, yeah, Pizza Hut, cost the same amount as the one from Round Table.
Okay.
How many toppings we need to add for them to be equal?
Okay, so you guys are all saying exactly what we want to hear. So we're looking for toppings, we're looking for equal cost, all of that. So now I'm going to challenge you. I want to see if you guys can write equations, because how many unknowns are we talking about here? Like, how many pizza companies are we working with?
Two.
So we're comparing two things. So how many equations do you guys think we should write?
Two.
Okay, that's your challenge. See if you can write the two equations.
I don't get it, because if the cost is just like, it's unknown, like how are we going to do this, like P plus R, or we're just going to leave it without the total?
But the two variables right here, they already give you the price.
So
you just got to figure it out.
That's what I'm trying to say, like, if we, oh my bad, if we don't know the cost, we need to try to look for it and add them to B so we can put the total of P plus R equals. You get me?
You could also, you could just put C for the variable, for the price, because the cost is unknown. But you're writing two equations too. So one with the variables and then one with the numbers.
So what was your guys' thoughts in writing this one?
But you put it on both sides. I didn't.
Since this one is already like the, that's the, I think you call it initial cost or price. And then the 90 cent is the one that is constantly moving.
So how did you know that the 90 cents was the one that was constantly moving?
Because it's saying that you're...
And what in the text tells you?
It says plus the 90 cents for each topping. So it says each. That means that you could keep adding it.
Okay. And then how did you know that this was the initial, like you had said?
Because it's saying that the pizza in general is just $6.80.
Okay. So Janessa, what did she just tell you?
She said that, okay, so this was the initial because... Wait, this one, right? You said it was initial?
You can do the second one if you want based on what she just said, so...
So this one was the initial because, like, she said that it's $7.30 plus. And then we were talking about... that and then this one was the, what was this word called again? The, not the initial. What was that word called?
It's constantly moving.
Yeah, that's that. Because if it's constantly moving, it's gonna be 90 for each topping.
Okay, so do you guys know, you're saying constantly moving, and you said from the text you found that it said for each, right? So instead of constantly moving, what term would you say? Because constantly moving, that's not really like a mathematical term. So what term would represent something that is constantly moving? I want to see if you guys can figure that part out.
Like I have it, but...
like right there, yeah. Right? So you guys have, your explanation is great, but we want to see if we can pull out that vocabulary out of you guys. So what does it mean when something's constantly moving? What would be that vocabulary we've used in the past? Or constantly changing? Because you don't know it, right? So I want you to think about it, see if you can figure it out, because I think it's right there. So I heard some great conversations. You guys were even using the text to help you try to answer the questions and why you put things the way you did. I do have one group that I'd like for them to share. And then if anyone wants to add in, that'd be even better. So I'm gonna pick on my juror and Janessa. I want you guys to give us the first equation for Pizza Hut. What from the text told you to use that? And then we are going to talk about it.
So the equation for a Pizza Hut is 6.80 plus 0.90 x equals to C.
And can you define your variables for all of us, please?
P plus R equals C.
What does X stand for? That's what I meant.
Oh, like what it means?
Yeah.
So it's basically saying that that's the additional cost, so you're adding that to the initial cost, of which is 6.80.
Okay, let's help my juror. She has a great equation, but what does her x mean? Like, it's just a letter variable right now. Like, what does that mean? What does it stand for?
For each topping.
Okay, so each topping. Okay, and then C would stand for what?
For the cost.
The cost. Okay. Now, using the text, why did she put the 680 here and the 90 cents there? And I want you to pull it from the text. What vocabulary in the text told you that is what it should look like? Do you guys want to share? Okay.
You go first.
You go.
Okay, so the $6.80 is the cost of a large pizza at Pizza Hut, and then the 90 cents, or the .90, is the cost for each topping. That's why she put X right by it, because we don't know how many toppings are needed. And that's why the cost is unknown.
Okay. I want to keep going with that. So mathematically, what word are we trying to say, but we're just, it's not there yet?
It's called the...
So for each, we talked about, she said like for every, what are some other words that all mean what you guys are saying right now? Okay, let's have a partner conversation. Think about that. If we don't get to the writing part, it's okay.
I don't know what it is. I feel like we used
it
yesterday.
Wait, the fancy word. What's the mathematical
word? Did we use the word yesterday?
We did not use this word when we were writing yesterday. We've used it before when we did the bowling problem.
I remember I wrote it down.
They look at the paper of the bowling. I don't know. I don't
even know. And we did it for another problem. I think for the baseball test, maybe? We've used that vocabulary word before. So what is that?
The rate of change.
Say it louder.
The rate of change.
The rate of change. So Elijah started off with slope, and Ernesto heard us say that, and he's like, wait a second, it's rate of change. So what is the rate for Pizza Hut?
90 cents
for each topping. Remember those vocabulary words, for each. So what would Round Table's rate be?
65 cents.
And what from the text tells you that?
For each.
The for each, right here. Okay, so we spent a long time talking about this text, but now you guys have a very, very thorough understanding of the text, the equations, what they mean, why we use what we used, the rate. We pulled out all of these vocabulary words. Rate was not in that text. Initial value was not in that text. Variable was not in that text, but yet you guys were able to pull that out based on the conversations you guys were having with each other. So we're gonna do one more thing. We're gonna set it up and then we'll pick this up where we left off because we gotta get to the rest of our objective. We need to start solving it. So we deconstructed and do all that stuff. I want you guys to at least set up the first part. Okay, so talk to your partner and see if you guys can set up how would you figure out this problem.
You can do a ratio. So you could put $6.80 and then under that.
You could make the X's try to look the same.
And you could just add that with the 90 cents.
So what did she do?
She inputted Y for Y.
So Y for Y. What method is she using?
She's using
the... You guys remember what it's called?
Distributive?
Say it louder and proud because you were right.
Substitution.
So tomorrow we'll get into the writing part of this and really figuring out how do we explain this to partners, how we solved, how can we write this in our own words.
Reflection and discussion. Reflect on the following questions. First, how did you observe the following focal content standards and supporting English language development standards being implemented in this grade 8 integrated English language development lesson? Expressions and Equations, Standard 8C. English Language Development, Part 1, Standard 1. Exchanging Information and Ideas. and Part 1, Standard 12A, Selecting Language Resources. Second, what features of integrated English language development did you observe in the lesson? Now pause the video and engage in a discussion with colleagues. The California Department of Education would like to thank the administrators, teachers, and students who participated in the making of this video. This video was made possible by the California Department of Education in collaboration with WestEd and Tambor Films.